Postmasters, dear guests, and Madam Postmaster in particular. Oops, I'm sorry, women are not allowed to speak loudly. I'm the only girl in my family, and yes, I am lucky enough that my parents have never said, I wish if I had another son, as they are already satisfied with one. Girls are always advised to not to raise voice and always to stay silent in any kind of situation. How many of you could raise your voice when it is required to do so? Yeah, but there is an opposite happened. We three friends gathered to share a light moment, and we saw that one of our friends was a little upset. I asked her, why are you so upset? She said, I am not upset. Later on, after 5 minutes, I asked her, I can see that you are not happy. On being asked, she said that yes, that something has happened, that something happens in her house, that her brother-in-law would come at home and would look at her in a very cheap and derogatory manner, of which she would feel offensive and feel uneasy. She said that she cannot raise her voice because her parents also says her not to do so, because her sister's marriage might get into trouble. How many of you girls face questions from your parents, like where are you going, by what time you would be coming back, with whom are you going, all these questions at a stretch? However, I feel that boys do not face such questions at a stretch. My mom used to give me lessons that Akriti, when you are walking on the street, you should look down and you should not smile in front of the shopkeepers, behave in a very reserved manner. You should not wear dresses up to knees length. Instead, I felt that women should be trained, women should be given lessons like when you are walking on the street, you should face, like you should walk with confidence. And whenever anyone is looking at you, just give them a harsh look. And don't ruin your life, because this is your life. Live the way you want and wear whatever you feel like. There's another incident. When a girl faced some different situation. It was my friend's birthday party, and she kept she would keep the party going till late night, and for society it is kept to be 9 o'clock. But at it was 8 o'clock. I got almost 10 calls from my mom. She was giving me lessons on how to leave the meeting how to leave the party in the middle. She was giving me tips so that I can leave the party. However, my brother would go and play dandiya with his friends, and he would never come back on the same day. Why is there so much surprise when they hear that a girl has come home on the next day? How many of you have carried an extra set of clothes when you are going out for a party? Because there is something, I went to my friend's house, and because we had to go to a party. And when I went to a house, I saw that a grandmother was sitting in a dining room, and she was reading newspaper. And she belonged to a person, she belonged to the age where people had old thoughts. I was waiting for my friend to come out in an elegant new dress and of knees length. But to my surprise, I saw that she came out in jeans and top. We left home, and I asked her, why didn't you come out in that dress which you had decided to wear? She said that her grandmother does not allow her to wear it. She went inside the public washroom to change the clothes and came out in the desired dress which she had decided to wear it. Why the girls are not allowed to wear the dress of their choice? Actually, the problem lies in the way society thinks. Radical change is required in the society's perception for women. The women are under constant scrutiny, of how they walk, what dress they are wearing, how they talk, they are under the, they suffer the nasty comments from the society. So I would urge all the beautiful ladies sitting here that don't shatter your dreams in the way society wants you to do so. You are the most beautiful creatures created by God and whom He has given all the strengths. So make full and better utilization of it. Raise your voice whenever it is required to do so. Wear the clothes whatever you feel like, because it is said that women who has voice, they are the most strongest person on earth. And there is another famous quote saying that any challenges that comes to women's path to destroy her, it is the woman who can defend all those challenges. What do you think, Madam Toastmaster?